Hello everyone, it's me again, and I'm finally bringing you another video covering my GMC Envoy, because I've finally done enough things to it to justify making an entire second vlog. And so without any further ado, we're just going to start right off. First off, we'll do the outside. So probably the most noticeable and most useless change is... God, it's so dirty. Some carbon fiber striping alongside. It's on both sides. I did it myself, so that's why it looks like shit. But I enjoyed it. New tires. Yes, these are different than the ones in the thumbnail. I took the thumbnail literally like a day before I bought the tires, so fucking deal with it. New valve stem covers, because why not? And speaking of tires, I actually had to replace this plastic mud flap thing because I broke one of the others. It doesn't look new because it's dirty, but I mean, the whole car is dirty. And while we're over here, in the last episode, there was quite a bit of paint chippage here, and it could use a touch-up, but after that episode, I put some nail polish on it, so it looks a bit better, but it could use a touch-up because it wears off over time, and it's been a while.
I had to get a new wiper blade for this rear windshield wiper because the other one was fucking trash. I also took off the SLT badge over here because a new one is like $25 shipped to me and I wasn't going to pay that, so I'd prefer it to look uniform and not have any SLT badges, so I took that off.
Working our way around, I actually did fix the bumper issue. Just straight up fucking screwed the bracket back on so that way it could connect to the actual frame like it's meant to. And that also allowed me to get the light back in. And so it's as sturdy as like a factory one is. So, I mean, it's good enough.
And I believe as far as the outside goes, that's everything. So let's go ahead and head inside. I installed those fucking $6 floor mats all around. I've also got a carbon fiber style steering wheel cover because it's comfy. And as far as mats go, I also got a nice Dickies brand rubber one for this back cargo area, but I didn't get it for such a great deal. I also swapped all the tools from my tool bag over into an actual toolbox I had laying around because, I mean, I can't use that for anything but carrying tools, but the bag I can actually use for other things, so, eh. Also, as you can see, it's not squatted, because I actually figured out the issue shortly after the last episode. And the reason it was leaking the air from the airbag suspension and squatting was just a faulty valve stem here where you can connect your inflator hose to air things up off the compressor. So I just put a new stem in it and tightened it down, and now it does not have any leaks. I've also put new door seals all the way around because the wind was kind of loud, and I had a friend of mine check it out, and together we came to the conclusion that it needed new seals, and that has mostly fixed the issue. The rest is probably just it being a shitty car or something. I also had to replace this because the old one ripped off, and I was able to get one of those for super cheap. And that pretty much does it for what I would consider non-functional mods, as if any of this is a mod really, but whatever. Real quick before we get onto the engine bay, let's do a quick mileage check. miles. And of course, check engine light is on, because why not? I hate my life. Now on to the stuff you all care about.
haven't really changed much other than I put a new fan clutch in there because it had quite a lot of wobble in play and was going to be kind of a future concern. Plus the fan speed was a little higher than it was supposed to be. And then I also put a new battery into it because for whatever reason, this car already needed a new battery because the one in it when I bought it was bad. And I mean, that's literally it for, you know, quote unquote functional mods. And so, yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm not forgetting anything. I think that's everything. Nothing special at all, but, you know, maybe enough to justify a second video. I figured it was time. I had actually considered making this thing elite and swapping it to manual transmission to get rid of this automatic. But after consulting with some friends of mine who have done manual swaps on similar vehicles and just doing some online research, I came to the conclusion it wasn't going to be worth the money or effort. Because since this is a 4.2 liter vehicle instead of the usual 5.3 liter Vortec vehicle, I would have some ECU problems if I was lucky enough to find a manual transmission from a 5.3 and somehow make it work in this. And the issue with that being just all the different harnesses and sensors and et cetera, et cetera. And even if I made all of that work, like I said, I'd have ECU issues. And if I somehow fixed that with some wizardry tuning or possibly getting a different ECU that would work, I would literally be in it for like $4,000, which is not even remotely worth it. Because as it sits right now, I have $6,000 in this car. And so I think I'm just going to sell it and hopefully find a manual. Besides, this car is a bit bigger than I like. So that's kind of the plan there. But until then, this thing is a good daily driver if you don't mind scum automatics, which I don't have a choice at the moment. So yeah, I think that is everything that I wanted to say. Probably not, but I don't know that I care. I hope you enjoyed, and I will possibly see you in the next one. Unless I get lucky and sell this and get a sweet, sweet manual. Peace out, guys.